Oh.
From Godspell. So, welcome if you're joining us on Zoom. And today we're thinking not just of the parable of the five talents, but we're thinking and preparing ourselves for Advent. So we're going to spend a moment as we gather our thoughts and we gather together. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
Also with you.
We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we're going to sing. I'm going to mute myself. If anybody's unmuted, mute yourself. We're going to sing Angel Voices, Ever Singing, and hopefully we'll have some music as well.
Thank you.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. We'll just spend a moment in quiet as we say sorry for ourselves. So let's say together. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. And so may Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So we're going to praise God with Ode to Joy.
Yep.
I'm going to mute myself.
Thank you.
So we're going to gather all our prayers together with the collect as we say together, Heavenly Lord, you long for the world's salvation. Stir us from apathy, restrain us from excess, and revive in us a new hope that all creation will one day be healed. In Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
I'm going to hand over to George.
Hold on, let me just find you, George.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you.
Oh, sorry, George, on mute.
I'm back again.
Yeah.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. For it is as if a man going on a journey summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. The one who had received the 5 talents went off at once and traded with them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had the 2 talents made 2 more talents. But the one who received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves who came and settled accounts with them, then the one who had received 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. And the one with 2 talents came forward, saying, Master, you handed over to me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. Then the one who received the 1 talent also came forward, saying, Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours. But his master replied, You wicked and lazy slave, you knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow and gather where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return, I would have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one with the 10 talents. For to all those who have more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him in the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, O Christ.
Thank you, Lord. I do pray that these words that I have to say may be of you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, one good thing about lockdown this time is that we don't seem to have had the ridiculous panic buying of toilet paper that we had the first time. I remember doing some shopping in March and seeing the shelves stripped bare of tins and pasta, and for some strange reason, black olives. I still haven't worked that one out. But the thing that became like gold dust was flour, as many people took up baking. I think many of us took up some hobbies that we maybe had put on the back burner for a while. This time round, I've noticed that craft things seem to be a little harder to get hold of. This is what people were panic buying this time round. I tried to get hold of some wool from a high street craft supplier, whose name shall be nameless, online, and they were pretty much out of stock of everything. Well, all of us have talents, even if we don't recognise them as such. For example, the government is still asking for people to come forward to join a team who can phone other people or deliver medicines to their door. They still need people just to make a simple phone call. Well, you're probably very familiar with the parable of the talents. I know I am. And it seems pretty straightforward to understand. But I think it's actually worth unpacking it a bit, as it does offer some interesting challenges that you may not have thought of. As an example, if we look where it comes in Jesus's story, it comes off the back of him criticizing the scribes and the Pharisees in chapter 23 of Matthew, with a whole list of accusations such as, "Woe to you, teachers of the law and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You shut the door of the kingdom of heaven in people's faces. You yourselves do not enter, nor will you let those enter who are trying to." And it talks about the tombs that are being whitewashed, yet awful on the inside. If you remember, there's a whole long list. Well, you have to keep that in mind when we look at this parable, because we begin to see the slave who buried his money could be the Jewish leaders. They had the law of Moses and the temple as the means to show God's grace and love for the world. And yet they hid it, making the law full of sub-clauses, such as hand-washing rules around eating, and making the temple a place for the elite. They made sinners outcasts, and non-Jews were labeled unclean. Jesus himself demonstrated again and again how God felt about those on the fringes, healing lepers and the blind and the deaf, the healing of the Syrophoenician's woman's daughter, the woman at the well, the woman caught in adultery, so on and so on and so on. That third slave buried his treasure. The Jewish leaders buried access to God. So far, so good. We can all feel a little smug now, thinking that at least we're not the Jewish leadership of the time, and we know that it's by God's grace and Jesus leading the path before us that we can be part of the banquet that this parable intimates. But before we get too smug, there are stark warnings in this parable. Remember, Matthew is writing his gospel for a church and for teaching purposes as well. So there's a stark message for those of us who read it. Firstly, what are we doing with the gift of God's grace, the knowledge of his saving love? Are we burying it, or are we investing it and sharing it and showing it? As a church here in Chels, even though we may not be meeting in person, how are we investing what God has given us so we may bring light and community and love to the community around us? What will God say when Jesus returns and looks at us? Well, we hope that he'll say, "Well done." But will he say, "You could have done more"? And remember, it's not Chandy that makes up the church. It's every individual member that makes up the whole. Secondly, the parable and other parables talk of the Master's return. Jesus will return. Also, we cannot, as this pandemic has proven, predict how long we have left on this earth. We're limited and need to lead our lives with this in mind. You heard the song from Godspell at the beginning of the service, a reminder as we approach this time of Advent that we need to prepare. That was John supposedly crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. But we need to prepare ourselves and our church for that day when we will face our triune God and upon his return, be prepared to answer that age-old question. Well, what have you done with your life? I support a child through the Compassion Project. He's called Ten. He lives in Indonesia. We had a video message from the leaders of the project in that country showing what they were doing, how they were visiting each of the families during the pandemic, helping children continue with their learning, praying with them, helping to feed families who had lost their jobs. One was telling of the children at their Sunday school who were slowly making a chandelier out of bamboo. The children themselves had decided they wanted to make it so that they could sell it and help to feed the children of the families who weren't as fortunate as them. To give you an idea of the level of poverty, I gave Ten a small extra donation for him and one for his family, for his birthday. And he wrote to thank me and told me he had bought a pair of shoes so that he could walk more comfortably to school, and his parents had bought a cow for their farm. On top of that challenge to the church, there is, of course, the familiar challenge to us. How do we invest our talents? A talent at the time was the equivalent of 15 years' labourer's wages. The word talent has come from that word. But we understand the word now to mean something that we're gifted at. But again, we recognise that a talent is a gift given to us, not something that we necessarily earn. I'm sure you were wowed by Fiona's violin playing at the All Souls evening service. I learned the violin, but I'm not sure who was more relieved when I gave up, me or my parents. Some can play the piano with a lot of practice, like myself, but my daughter Jenny reached grade 8 in piano and flute and a teaching diploma in piano. And she can play the saxophone, the clarinet, and the guitar as well. Now that's a gift. And we all have gifts, even if we don't recognise them as such. We may have the gift of a good job and spare money, or the gift of time. We may be good at getting alongside people, or even making tea. Trust me, that's a gift if you can make a decent cup of tea. We may be good at gardening or have the gift of a car. We may have IT skills or the gift of a good education. As you all have seen, the children in Indonesia are using what they have, and they have so little, to reach out to those who don't. You may be good at writing letters or cards. You may be physically fit. In the parable, the servants were slaves. They were owned by their master. We, however, unlike the slaves, are free to choose what we do with what we have. But we need to recognize that all we do have has been given to us by God. When we do that, firstly, we're grateful. But secondly, is that understanding that we need to do something with what we have. I can't dictate what you do. But as we approach Advent, we can think and pray about what we have and how God may choose to use us. We are, again, of course, during a period of lockdown when we might have more time on our hands. Maybe this lockdown, it's a time to prepare, time to think about what God has given us rather than, and what we can do rather than to focus on what we can't. I'm going to leave you with a clip from YouTube. I don't know whether you're familiar with Olive and Mabel, who've become a bit of an internet hit during the previous lockdown, when their owner, Andrew Cotter, a sports commentator, found himself with no work and started to make little commentaries about them. Things soon snowballed, sometimes literally. And here's a clip of them, hopefully, displaying some of their talents.
You all see that? No.
You can see a screen.
Is that better?
Yep. Yep.
I'm just saying that we all have to do our bit, and there are plenty of jobs that you could be doing around the house. Well, official food taster's not a job. And I'm left doing everything while you two just eat or sleep or mess about. And what about you? Bed quality examiner. Again, not a job. It's not. Just give me a hand and get me the Phillips head screwdriver. No, that's not it. That's not even close to being it. Yes, it's great, the noises it makes, but I can't turn screws with a Christmas pudding. It's fine, I'll get it myself. All I'm saying is that you get meals and accommodation and walks. Not now. And wagging your tail isn't quite enough. You've got guard dogs. Yeah, because burglars hate being vigorously licked. Just saying that you've both got to have a think about yourselves and perhaps do something in return. Okay, that's actually pretty impressive. Well, that's a start. I'm not quite sure how you've done it, but somehow you've redeemed yourselves. Ah, that's a shame. Yeah, you did the handles, didn't you? Yeah, I thought so. Well, at least you tried. Well, I really don't understand how you did it. Mostly because it was supposed to be a coffee table.
I hope you enjoyed that. Are we going to affirm our faith now? And so, do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Hand over to Sue for the prayers.
Lord God, we thank you for the gifts that we possess. Help us to use these gifts in our daily lives to help others and show your love. Lord Creator, we praise you for the wondrous world. May we take the time during lockdown to appreciate the beauty and perfection of nature all around us. The simple things we take for granted, the earth that produces and nourishes us. Lord, transform our hearts and minds so we can care for our world and share with one another. May we respect other people's needs and circumstances. Lord, let your love bind us together. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Protector, we pray for peace in the world, a greater understanding between nations, so we can live alongside each other with mutual respect. We pray for America and their new president-elect. Give his government clarity and guidance in the decisions they make. We pray for the UK as we prepare to leave the EU. May the governments move beyond the divisions and come together as good neighbours. Lord, we especially pray for those nations living with conflicts and destruction, causing displacement, poverty and hunger. Lord, as they pour out their anxieties and fears, may they receive your strength and peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Most High, we pray for your church. May you fill us with your spirit of love and unity. May all Christians be able to praise you without being in danger or be persecuted. We pray for Chandy and our church leaders, the demands placed upon them, especially due to changes during lockdown. May your spiritual gift help them maintain the path you have for them and guide them in their decisions in changing circumstances. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for all those in our community who are finding it difficult in another lockdown. Be with those who are facing isolation, hardship, fear, and anxiety. Let them know you are near them and enable them to feel safe. We are extremely thankful for all our medical professionals and caregivers who are dedicated to their patients. Keep them healthy and safe in their place of work. We pray, Lord, for all the scientific researchers for their gifts of knowledge and understanding for the treatment of COVID. The many hours of research and testing leading them to a discovery of a vaccine that could save many lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Healing God, we pray for those who suffer in body, mind or spirit. We remember Philip, Brian, Lucy, Jean, Philip, Sandra, Beryl, Amelia, Isla, Maureen, Mary and Rose. Lord, we bring forward to you those known to us in need of your healing. Lord, in times of sickness, we turn to you to be our comforter and alleviate our worries with your love. We remember those who have died recently and those whose year's mind falls this week. May their loved ones rest in your peace. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
So in whatever language or tradition you wish to say it. Let's say of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. So we are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us therefore keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Have a go at wishing each other and giving each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Okay. I will need your words though.
Yeah.
There we go. And so in union we say together, together but apart, in union with Christian people throughout the world and across the ages, we remember that praying together and meditating on your word gathers us as your body. Together we offer you praise and thanksgiving. Come, Lord Jesus, dwell in us and send your Spirit so that we may be filled with your presence. And so we say together, Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace and opened the gate of glory. May we who are Christ's body live his risen life, bring life to others and give life to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we're going to sing, Be Thou My Vision. And so may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Rest in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Amen.
I'm going to stop recording.